Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to crochet this beautiful motif. I think it's very summer appropriate. We have a little daisy. If you are more advanced, you actually can use a different color for this thing around. I didn't feel like playing, but one solid color looks pretty as well. So this is the front, this is the right side, and this is the wrong side. So keep that in mind when you are creating. We are gonna be using chains, single crochets, double crochets, and trebles. A really good way to practice your stitches. As usual, I'm using the Lion Brand Comfy Cotton Blend and a 5mm hook. Obviously, you will use your yarn that requires your hook size. If you are planning on making something with it, make a sample. It's going to be easier to determine the size and whatever you need. Without any further ado, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, ring the bell, grab your yarn, crochet hook, let's get to work. We will begin with a magic ring. I will show you how I'm making it. So hold on to the tail like this, wrap it around your two fingers, cross like this, and hold it with your ring finger. Go underneath the first strand, grab the second, and pull it through. Let me show it one more time. You hold the tail, go around the fingers, crisscross, hold it with your ring finger, go underneath the first strand, grab the second, and pull through. And hold on, still hold on to the tail. So you're grabbing these two strands, then strands, moving them to the side. There we go. And quickly chain one. And now we secured it. And you can see how the tail will be moving. Okay, this does not count as a stitch. We will put 8 single crochets in this ring. 1, 2, 3, and 8. Okay, so now you're gonna tighten it without actually closing the gap. You don't want it to be closed because otherwise they're gonna be squished together. And slip stitch into the first. This is our round number one. For round number two, you will single crochet into the next stitch, chain three, single crochet into the next, chain three, and this is how you're gonna go all the way to the end. One single crochet, chain three, single crochet, chain three. You will have to end up with 8 single crochets divided by chain three. 8. And now to finish off the round, we are gonna chain three and slip stitch into the first single crochet. And now we have 2, 4, 6, 8 chain three spaces. Okay. So for the next round, all we're gonna do is single crochet into each chain three space. We'll put 3 single crochets. So as you slip stitched, chain one, and 3 single crochets into this space, then 3 into the next chain three space, 3 into the next, and because we had 8 chain three spaces times 3 stitches, 3 single crochets in each one of them, you should end this round with 24 single crochets total. And I will slip stitch into the first single crochet of the round. like so. Okay, chain three, actually chain four, that counts as a treble. Into the next single crochet we will put three trebles. This is going to be a struggle. Yarn over twice, insert the hook into the designated stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. We need to put two more. Yarn over twice, into the designated stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. One more. Yarn over twice, into the designated stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. That's our three treble. Then a treble into the next. So we had three single crochets and we utilized all three of them from this section. Now we will chain three and we will move into this chain three section. I mean, not chain three, three single crochet section. And we'll repeat treble into the first from the group. Three trebles into the second stitch of that group. One through two, and the third one. And now a treble into the third single crochet of this group. And chain three. Moving into the next group, same, 1, 3, 1, chain three, 1, 3, 1, so on till the end. Okay, once you've completed all the groups and utilized all your single crochets, you will chain three and slip stitch into the fourth chain from the beginning to complete the round. And this is what we have. We have our eight sections. If you don't have eight sections, means that you missed something somewhere here in the very beginning. Okay, let's continue. Now we will reverse everything. We will put five trebles together. So all of them have one point. So a treble is chain four, one unfinished treble will be chain three, and then we will have to utilize these stitches. So yarn over twice, insert the hook into the next stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two, and don't finish it yet. Moving to the next one, yarn over twice, insert the hook into the stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. Again, leave it unfinished. Yarn over twice, let's move into the next, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. There is our fourth. Yarn over twice, into the fifth, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Now we have our five trebles and we will put, they all need to have one point. So yarn over, pull through all the stitches on the loop. And here we go, they're all five trebles are together. Chain three, 1, 2, 3. Here you can work either into the chain three space or into the second chain, totally up to you. we will put a double crochet chain 3, double crochet into the same space. Chain 3, and we are back at our group. We will do the same. Yarn over twice, insert the hook into the first stitch of the group, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Same into the next, only through 2 and through 2. There's the second unfinished, and let's repeat through all 5. And if it's too fast for you, on the right hand side of the corner there is a little of the video, there is a little toggle on the screen. Hit on it and adjust the playback speed. You can make it either slower or faster, however you like. So you have your 5 trebles unfinished plus your chain from here. Yarn over, pull through all the stitches, and there we have. Then again, chain 3, working into the chain 3 space, double crochet. I don't know why they put double crochets on the chart, but we're gonna follow it. Chain 3 and double crochet into the same. Then again, chain 3 and 5 trebles together. So this is what we have, and you should end up obviously with 8 these little petals, but don't forget your chain 3, double crochet, chain 3, double crochet in each space right here. Okay, and I'll meet you at the end. And once all of them are done, we are going to complete the row with the round with chain 3, double crochet, chain 3, double crochet into the last space, chain 3, slip stitch into the tip of this one right here, like so. And this is what we have. And now let's go ahead and do the last round. We will have to slip stitch our way into the chain 3 space right here. So let's use slip stitch however you like. I mean, I don't know if there is any other way to slip stitch, but into the double crochet and then into the space. Okay. Now here we will chain 4, counts as a treble. We add 2 more, so the total of 3 trebles. This is going to be our corner. Okay, then chain 3, then it's asking for 3 trebles together. So we already know how to do those. Yarn over twice, go around, pull through only 2, then again yarn over twice, pull through only 2, and again the third time we're pulling only through 2. We got our 3 incomplete, and now we're yarn over and pull through all. Here we got our trebles together, chain 3, and in also again in the same space, 3 freestanding trebles, not with 1 point. So 1, 2 and 3. So all this good stuff in one space. We're going to move all the way here. Now into this double crochet, we'll put double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. Double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. Into this leg. Now let's work into this leg. Same thing, double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. Double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. Now chain 3 and move into the next. So middle corner, corner. This will be a middle, then this will be another corner, another middle, another corner, another middle. Okay, so these are our corners. So now into the corner. 3 trebles, standing 1 by 1. So 1. 2, 3, slide them, then chain 3, 3 trebles together, pull through 2, pull through 2, start the next one, and start the third one. Complete them, chain 3, move everything to the right, and 3 more trebles, and our corner is complete. Chain 3, we're moving into this V stitch or double crochets. Into the first leg, we're putting double crochet, chain 3, double crochet. Into the other leg, same thing, double crochet. Chain 3, double crochet, and let's see. And now the picture is clearer. Corner, corner, side, side. So in here you will put a corner, you will repeat these. In here, and this one, you will repeat this. Again the corner, and again this. Okay, go all the way around. And to complete this round, I'm going to chain 3 and slip stitch into the fourth chain from the beginning, like so. Then chain 1, pull a long tail and cut the yarn off. This is how it looks like right now. Let me go steam it and come back and see the finished, complete and beautiful part. There it is in all its glory. A beautiful daisy inside, or call it whatever you want to call it. To me it looks like a daisy, and as I say with all the motifs, you know, they all require a proper blocking, proper steaming. This was just a very quick. So this is the right side, and this is how the wrong side looks like. Keep that in mind when you make any projects. I think it's really pretty for summer to add it to garments, or to even light throws or blankets. And yeah, what do you see making with this motif. How do you like it, by the way? Leave me a comment below. How do you guys like this one? I kind of like it. All right, this was it for today. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe, ring the bell, leave me a comment down below, and you take care. Have a fantastic weekend. I will see you next time. Bye.